We've bought one of the most desirable sports cars of all time, a Porsche 997 Carrera 2. And at £15,000, it's the cheapest 911 in the country. The low price is down to the engine. It has suspected bore score damage. We don't yet know how bad the problem is. Best case, it's only one cylinder. Worst case, we could be looking at a full engine rebuild. This is a bore scope. It's fitted with a tiny little camera, which, now that I've taken the spark plugs out, I can fit all the way through the cylinder head and inside the cylinder to take a closer look. I'm starting with cylinder number 6 because this is the one on these engines that gets hottest. This is the one where that misshaping of the cylinder typically tends to occur first. So, here we go. You can start to now see inside the walls of the cylinder. If I turn it round, I can get a full 360-degree view. Oh, there it is. I can see it. Score marks up and down the cylinder wall. Bore score. Now, part of me is quite pleased with myself for my early diagnosis of this problem. But the other part of me, well, a bit more concerned because I've checked one out of the 6 cylinders and already we've found signs of the problem. Now, if they were all damaged in the same way, this could end up being a very expensive repair job. There's only one way to find out. I've got to check them all.
Oh, yeah, it's got it in there as well. Actually, that's quite bad. On to the other side.
Expert opinion varies as to how common bore scoring is in these water-cooled 997 engines. The consensus is that around 4% will go on to develop the problem in at least one cylinder. It's looking like our engine is one of the unlucky ones, and I'm worried that our worst fears of an expensive engine rebuild could be about to come true. Now, having checked all 6 cylinders, I can confirm that cylinders 4 and 6 on this side of the engine have a pretty severe bore score issue. What I can't yet be sure of, because that small blurry screen on the bore scope, is just how bad it is. Cylinder number 1 also looked like it might have a problem, so things could still get worse on that front. This is the workshop where all the magic happens. What an amazing place. And through those doors is where I've been stripping our engine down to find out exactly how serious the problems are and maybe how much it might cost us to get it fixed. Morning, Grant.
Elvis, how are you?
Yeah, good, mate.
Good man.
I see you've found it.
I'm afraid so. And you're right. We feared the worst, and there it is.
Yeah.
You've got classic bore scoring, I'm afraid.
Yeah, I mean, I saw that with the endoscope. That's the worst one, isn't it? There's a couple of little signs on some of the others.
Just starting in areas, yeah, but that's your main issue.
OK, and I mean, in terms of a fix for this,
yep.
I mean, how many of them do you think we actually need to set about repairing?
The problem there is that you've left with 5 that are exactly the same material, exactly the same design, and so consequently have the inherent weak spots.
So at some point, they probably will suffer like
yes.
this one.
Yeah.
OK, and what's the solution then? Because you can't just take that out.
Over the last 15 years, we've developed our own solution of repair. We completely machine out the cylinder. We replace it with an aluminium alloy wet liner with much better surface bore material. We're going with a nickel ceramic plating. Mm-hmm. It's the same type of material as Porsche used in the air-cooled 911s, GT3, turbo, much, much more durable.
So cars that never suffered with a bore score?
You've got it, yeah.
Right, makes sense. OK, well, I mean, look, the decision for me is going to come down to what this costs.
You've already made a big saving by bringing it here as it is. If we were looking purely at just fixing the immediate issue, a new cylinder going in is £600 plus VAT.
Okay.
To change all 6 is £2,500 plus VAT.
I mean, in my mind, having got to this point where it's stripped into all these pieces, it sort of makes sense to do it all. I mean, I just hope we're going to end up getting our money back in the end. I'm at a specialist Porsche engineering firm, and to save us some money, I'm going to do as much of the work as I can myself. Before I start, the engine's vapor blasted to remove any debris from the block and leave it all completely clean. Then my job starts over at the CNC machine. So now the block is lined up on the bed of the CNC machine, what we're going to do is put a tool in here that's going to take away the first part of the cylinder liner. And that's the hardened material, the one that has the problem with bore score, the one that's scored deep down inside the cylinder bore itself. There we go. And so the CNC machine actually tells me exactly which tool I need for the job. It's tool number 81. And if I come over to the shelf, tool number 81 is right there. It's got a carbide tip on it, which is incredibly hard for taking away this incredibly hard material. Okay, so safety goggles on, and we're ready to fire it up. These CNC machines are called fly cutters. They operate at around 500 RPM and have interchangeable tools, each with a different tip. So what this first tool's doing is taking around about 4 millimetres of material off the cylinder liner. It looks like such a brutal process, just tearing away material from this precision engine, but we're going to replace it, of course, with something that's going to prevent these problems from happening in the future. Next, it's tool number 82, which also has a carbide tip and will remove a further 3 millimetres of aluminium wall from each cylinder. After that, it's one final tool swap to another different blade. This one has a PCD diamond edge. So as you can see, what's happening here is it's actually removing the remaining material from each of the cylinders, and that will allow us to then put our new cylinders in this position, in their place. The final part of this process is a really interesting one. It's a little modification that the guys here have developed over time, and by removing some material from the water jacket around this engine block, they've managed to address the balance of coolant between the block and the cylinder head and eliminate some of the hot spots that have caused some of the problems this engine suffered with in the first place. So that's the machining of the block now done. Now I can take it through to another machine shop where they're going to turn down some brand new oversized cylinders to fit these specific ball sizes. Back at the workshop, the epic job of rebuilding the mammoth flat six engine continues. I've cleaned and refitted the original manifolds, injectors and gearbox, along with all the ancillaries. I've also replaced any of the hoses and pipes that were starting to show their age, which amounts to a small outlay compared to the work that we just carried out on the cylinders. Now, I spent about £3,500 on getting this engine rebuilt because I did most of it myself. If you had to take this to Hartech and have the same sort of thing done, it would probably cost upwards of £10,000, which is a huge amount of money. But the point is, even by spending £10,000 on rebuilding an engine like this, you can still turn a car like this, a great car but with a serious problem, into a profit. It doesn't have to end up on the scrap heap.
Mate, I'm going to level with you. I have had a few sleepless nights, not only over the money we've got invested in this car, but also the money invested in the bore score issue. So, is it now fixed?
It is, mate. I've had my own sleepless nights, but look at that. Yes. It's fixed and back in. And I'll tell you what, we have spent a huge amount of money, but that is now one of the strongest Porsche engines you will find anywhere. I have remachined the entire block to take new liners that will not only fix the bore score, but hopefully prevent it happening for thousands and thousands of miles into the future. I've done the IMS bearing and the crankshaft bearings, which, as you know, weak points on this thing.
Mate, that is fantastic.
Yeah, I mean, I've got quite a few low speed miles to do just to bed it in, but then I'm really looking forward to sticking my right foot down and seeing what this thing can do.
But you know what? You can stick your right foot down because there is a Porsche event coming up at one of your old stomping grounds, Silverstone Race Circuit.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, good to take it there.
Yeah, it'd be fantastic to take it there. Not only that, if I put it out on the Porsche bulletins that we're bringing this car along, hopefully that might mean a potential buyer could turn up at the same time and we can get it sold.
Well, mate, that sounds like a plan. I'll get these retro styling bits on and these fancy wheels and we'll get it out on the road.
Lovely. Top work.
It's been a long road to recovery and resuscitating our 997 hasn't been cheap. We paid £15,000 for the car. I spent a total of £3,500 on the new cylinders, bearings and recoated pistons for the engine. Whilst Mike paid £745 for the ducktail spoiler. The replica Fuchs wheels cost £1,360 and the graphics were £200, giving us a grand total of £20,805. It's a lot of money, but it'll all be worth it to see our Porsche back on the racetrack where it belongs.
Click here to subscribe.